Welcome everyone. Let's go through next set of questions on the state and all. So we have the set state method, which is actually updating the state object, right? So set state also have the callback function. Using that callback functions, you can trigger some actions whenever you are updating the state. Okay. So what is the store in Redux? The store is a JavaScript object that holds the application state. So Redux is actually managing the state tree, a big state tree, which is like consider a commercial applications where you are actually storing the profile information, account information, transactional information. So all that information at the client side state will be inside a single JSON object. And you can action it with the help of getState method, or you can dispatch an action onto the Redux using dispatch methods. Okay. So what is the children? So in the JSX expressions, you might have seen the expression this.props.children, right? So that is actually one of the way where you can include the children inside one component, right? So in the JSX expression that contains both an opening tag and a closing tag that contains between those tags is passed to the component. So this.props.children is actually a way where you can encapsulate the component inside another component. So there is a parent component. So this used in the routing, there is a parent component JSX. In the division, you just put this.props.children. It will include all the child component inside that. Okay. So whenever we do iterations, like there is a list component and we are iterating onto the list item component. So key plays a unique role. So key helps React to identify which item has changed or added or removed. So that key is actually keep tracking onto the individual child component of the parent component. So it is helping React to identify which particular child component has a triggered event to the parent component and where the state has changed for the child component. So this is the best way to pick a key. So that should always be unique. So like you can create an index onto the loop and pass that in the key parameter in the child component. So HOCs, higher order component, a well-defined term in the React. Higher order component is a function that takes a component and returns a new component. Okay, so higher order functions, if you are aware about higher order functions in JavaScript, are those functions which accept a function as an argument and which may or may not return a function in the output. Okay, higher order functions are those functions which accept a function as an argument. So higher order component is a function that takes a component and returns a new component. The most commonly a Redux connect function. So Redux connect function, what it is doing, in the connect we are passing the component definitions and it is returning another component to us. So if you see the container component in the Redux, what we write in the bottom, we are writing the connect, we are passing the map state to the props, map state pass to the props, and passing the component name as an argument. So this itself is wrapping up this Redux container in your React container and giving you the new React component. So references used in the React component. Reference are used to get the reference of the DOM node. This dot reference name dot references dot get DOM node dot value. So you are triggering get DOM node to get that DOM node. Now you can get the value, you can get the whatever the attribute you can access from that DOM node. So when you use the reference are used for managing the focused text selections, triggering the animations or getting the values from them. Okay. So Redux Saga and Thunk we have already covered. So these are the questions which are at the next level, which you should be aware of how to answer them.